वेलकम टू फ्री ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ फिजिक्स विद लंबोज सर। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस लर्न टू मोर कंसेप्ट्स रिगार्डिंग द प्रेशर। फर्स्ट वन इज द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर और टोटल प्रेशर, एंड द सेकेंड कंसेप्ट इज द गॉज प्रेशर। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न अबाउट एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर एंड वी कम टू नो दैट at any point atmospheric pressure is nothing but weight of air column of unit cross sectional area starting from that point and extending up to top of atmosphere. The weight exerted by air column of unit cross sectional area at that point is called atmospheric pressure at that point. And we come to know that atmospheric pressure is maximum at the surface of Earth, that is at the sea level. And that atmospheric pressure, that maximum atmospheric pressure is called as normal atmospheric pressure. So let us discuss two more concepts regarding absolute pressure and gauge pressure. So first of all, we will find expression for absolute pressure, which is also called as a total pressure. And for that purpose, we will consider a tank which is open to air and it is filled with liquid like water. So to find the absolute pressure, we have considered a tank or vessel filled with liquid like water of density rho. The diagram explaining this tank filled with water is this. So you can consider this one is a vessel or this one is a tank which is open to atmosphere. And this tank is filled with liquid or water having density rho. So in this diagram, this is the free surface of liquid which separates air medium and water medium. So in this case, first of all, we will find pressure due to imaginary cylinder of liquid. So in the previous lecture, we find the expression for pressure due to liquid column or pressure due to fluid column. That expression we will refer here. So pressure due to imaginary cylinder of fluid. In this diagram, this one is the imaginary cylindrical liquid column, you can say water column. The height of that liquid column is h. The cross-sectional area of that liquid column is a. So such imaginary cylinder of liquid we will consider here. So consider a cylinder, imaginary cylinder having horizontal base. This one is the horizontal base of cross sectional area A, and the height of that imaginary cylinder is h. So here h, which is equal to h1 minus h2. So in this diagram, what is h1, what is h2? h1 and h2 are the two levels inside the liquid. So these levels are measured from some reference point, and here the bottom of this vessel is considered as a reference point, and from that reference point h2 is the level, h1 is the level, and the heights of that level are measured in upward from this reference point, such that h1 will be greater than h2, and from that we can say that h1 minus h2 will be equal to h. That will give you height of that cylinder. So where h equal to h1 minus h2, and this h1 and h2 are heights measured from reference point, and in this tank our reference point will be the bottom of that tank or vessel. या bottom पासून H2 point ची height, या bottom पासून H1 point ची height आपण measure केलेली आहे. Heights H1 and H2 increasing upward, कारण bottom पासून आपण measure करतोय म्हणजे H1 will be greater than H2. That's why we have taken the difference H1 minus H2. So such a imaginary cylinder of liquid that we have considered here. And pressure due to liquid column we have derived in the previous lecture. So in this liquid we have considered imaginary cylinder of that liquid, and that imaginary cylinder which encloses a liquid, that liquid has mass m. So mass of liquid in imaginary cylinder. Secondly, P1 and P2 in this diagram. What is that P1 and P2? So P1 is pressure at level H1, at height H1, and P2 is pressure at height H2. And we know that pressure depends upon depth of point inside the liquid. As point H2 is at more depth than point H1, that's why pressure at point H2 will be greater than pressure at point H1. That means P2 will be greater than P1 here. So P1 and P2, these are the pressure of liquid at points H1 and H2, or you can say at level H1 and H2. Liquid ची जी pressure आहे ती P1 आणि P2 आपण consider केलेले आहेत. Next, rho, density of that liquid, म्हणजे water इथं consider केले, त्या water ची density आपण rho consider केलेले आहे. After that H, what is that H? Will be the difference between the two heights, two levels, H1 minus H2, height of imaginary cylinder of liquid. Now A, cross-sectional area of cylinder, you can see here, this is the bottom surface of cylinder, this is the top surface of cylinder, cross-sectional area A. And Z will be acceleration due to gravity at this place. So this is about imaginary cylinder that we have considered. That cylinder is of liquid, imaginary cylinder of liquid that we have considered, and the terms related with that imaginary cylinder that we have explained here. Now, the vertical forces acting on the cylinder, you can see in this diagram, there are total three forces which are acting on that cylinder in vertical direction. Out of that, the two forces are acting vertically downward and only one force is acting vertically upward. Out of that, this force F1 bar is acting on the top surface of that imaginary cylinder due to liquid above the cylinder. So F1 bar is the force due to liquid above cylinder acting downward on the top surface of that imaginary cylinder. म्हणजे ह्या imaginary cylinder चा हा जो top surface आहे त्याच्या above up to free surface पर्यंत जे liquid आहे त्या liquid न exert केलेला force F1 bar आहे, and it is acting on top surface of the imaginary cylinder vertically downward. Now, the second force, F2 bar. This second force is due to liquid below bottom surface of that cylinder. Je liquid cylinder cha bottom cha below ahe, that liquid is exerting force F2 bar on that bottom surface of the cylinder, and it is directed vertically upward. So the second force, F2 bar, you can see here, F2 bar is due to liquid below this imaginary cylinder. Yeah, imaginary cylinder cha below je liquid ahe, that liquid exerts force F2 bar, and it is directed vertically upward on bottom surface of that cylinder. So these are the two forces, due to liquid above the cylinder and due to liquid below the cylinder. Now, third force is also there, and that force is the gravitational force due to weight of liquid enclosed by that cylinder, mg. See here, third force, the gravitational force on liquid enclosed in cylinder. म्हणजे ह्या इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडरनं जे लिक्विड इन्क्लोज केलेलं आहे त्या लिक्विडचं वेट विच इज इक्वल टू ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स अँड दॅट ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स इक्वल टू एम जी ऍक्टिंग व्हर्टिकली डाऊनवर्ड. सो इन दिस वे वी फाइंड आउट थ्री फोर्सेस विच आर ऍक्टिंग ऑन द सिलेंडर इन व्हर्टिकल डायरेक्शन. नाव वी नो दॅट द टँक इन विच liquid that we have considered, it is in static equilibrium. As the liquid in cylinder is in static equilibrium, what happens? Forces acting on cylinder, the vertical forces acting on cylinder, they are balanced. That means total upward force acting on the cylinder becomes equal to total downward force acting on the cylinder. What is the reason? Because as the liquid in the tank or in cylinder is at rest, that is in static equilibrium, that's why vertical forces acting on cylinder, they are balanced. Therefore, we can write here, total upward force acting on cylinder is equal to total downward force acting on cylinder. And if you see in this diagram, there is only one upward force is acting on cylinder, that is F2 bar. But there are two downward force which are acting on the cylinder, F1 bar and EMG. So in magnitude, if we write this equation, then we will get, see here, this is the total upward force, magnitude of total upward force, and this is the magnitude of total downward force which is acting on that cylinder. Now, you can see here, the top surface of imaginary cylinder cross-sectional area A, bottom surface of imaginary cylinder cross-sectional area A. That's why we can find force acting on top surface of cylinder. We know that pressure equal to force upon area. That's why force equal to pressure into area. So F1, we can write like this. F1 equal to P1 into A. What is F1? What is P1? F1 is the force acting on top surface of imaginary cylinder. And P1 is the pressure at height H1. That means at the same top surface. That's why F1 equal to P1A. This is the force on top surface of cylinder. Similarly, we can find the force on bottom surface of cylinder. F2 equal to, see here, F2 equal to P2 into A. This is the force on bottom surface of cylinder. Now, we will calculate mass of liquid enclosed by this imaginary cylinder. See here, mass of liquid column enclosed by the imaginary cylinder in terms of density. We know that mass equal to density into volume. So, we get the mathematical equation like this. Mass m equal to density into volume. Instead of writing this volume, we can write A into H. So, and this H is nothing but height of that imaginary cylinder, which is equal to H1 minus H2. So, the value of mass, value of force F1 and value of force F2, we can substitute in equation 1. Therefore, equation 1 becomes, what is that equation? F2, which is total upward force, equal to total downward force. In this equation, we will substitute the value of F2, F1 and M. The equation will become like this. See here, this is the value of F2, this is the value of F1, and this one is the value of M, mass of liquid column enclosed by the imaginary cylinder. So in this equation, cross-sectional area is common in all the three terms, and that common term gets cancelled from the both side. Therefore, the equation becomes P2 equal to P1 plus H1 minus H2 into rho g. Or this equation can also be written by taking the value of H1 minus H2 as H. You can see in the diagram, what is H? H is the height of this imaginary cylinder of liquid, which is equal to H1 minus H2. So this equation can also be written as P2 equal to P1 plus H rho g. So this is expression for pressure at level H2. Manje H2 is the point inside that liquid. Ani H2 points towards a total pressure jar aplyala find out karayche asel P2, that pressure equal to sum of pressure exerted by liquid above the cylinder, manje cylinder cha above असणाऱ्या लिक्विड न एक्झर्ट केलेलं प्रेशर P1 प्लस प्रेशर ड्यू टू लिक्विड कॉलम, ह्या लिक्विड कॉलम न एक्झर्ट केलेलं प्रेशर प्लस द प्रेशर एक्झर्टेड बाय लिक्विड अबाव धिस सिलेंडर. सो दिस इज एक्सप्रेशन फॉर प्रेशर ऍट लेवल H2 और ऍट पॉइंट H2. अँड युजिंग धिस इक्वेशन 2, ह्या इक्वेशन 2 चा यूज करून अपन एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर किंवा टोटल प्रेशर एट अ पॉइंट इनसाइड द लिक्विड किंवा एट अ पॉइंट आउटसाइड द लिक्विड वी वांट टू डिराइव. सो देयर आर टू केसेस दैट वी वांट टू लर्न. सी हियर, इन केस फर्स्ट वी वांट टू फाइंड प्रेशर एट डेप्थ डी बिलो लिक्विड सरफेस. म्हणजे एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर किंवा टोटल प्रेशर एट डेप्थ डी below liquid surface, that we want to derive the expression. So for that purpose, we will make one adjustment like this. See here, in this adjustment, in this diagram, the top surface of imaginary cylinder is shifted to the free surface of liquid at level H1. You can see here at level H1. Manje ha imaginary cylinder jo inside the liquid hota, तो अपन शिफ्ट केला जेणेकरून त्याचा टॉप सरफेस फ्री लिक्विड सरफेस मध्ये येईल. सो लेट द टॉप ऑफ इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडर, द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडर इज शिफ्टेड टू द सरफेस ऑफ लिक्विड, फ्री सरफेस ऑफ लिक्विड, अँड धिस लेवल बी एच वन. सो धिस ऍडजस्टमेंट वी हॅव डन. नाव द इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडर ॲज शोन इन दिस डायग्राम इज हॅव्हिंग हाईट एच. And this H2 and H1, in this case, the reference point from which H1 and H2 are measured is nothing but free surface of liquid. And if free surface of liquid upon reference point get asal, then H1 will become 0 and H2 will become equal to H or D, depth. So let H2, which is equal to H, which is equal to D. This is the depth of some point below the liquid surface. Manje ha jo free liquid surface distoy, tya free liquid surface cha inside la ekada point apan consider kelela ahe H2. Tyachi depth itha ahe D. After that, this P0. P0 is the atmospheric pressure at the surface of liquid. And that will be P1. So P1, which is equal to P0, is the atmospheric pressure at the surface of liquid, that is at height H1. Now we will refer here pressure due to liquid column. See here, expression for pressure at level H2 that we have just derived, that expression we will refer here. So this is expression for pressure at level H2. H2 या ठिकाणच्या प्रेशरची व्हॅल्यू, which is sum of pressure exerted by liquid above the imaginary cylinder plus pressure due to liquid column. This expression we will consider here. And in this expression, we will substitute the values. In equation 2, we will substitute the following values. Which values? Instead of P2, we will write P, which will give you pressure at depth D below the liquid surface. So instead of P1, we will substitute P0. Instead of H2, we will substitute D. And H1, we will take as a 0. कारण या ठिकाणच्या हाइट्स जे आहेत दैट हाइट्स आर मेजर्ड फ्रॉम फ्री सरफेस ऑफ लिक्विड. इन दिस डायग्राम यू कैन सी हियर द हाइट्स आर मेजर्ड फ्रॉम फ्री सरफेस ऑफ लिक्विड इन डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. दैट्स व्हाई H1 विल बिकम 0 एंड H2 विल बी H व्हिच इज इक्वल टू D. सो व्हिच वैल्यूज दैट वी वांट टू सब्स्टिट्यूट इन इक्वेशन 2. H1 इक्वल टू 0, P1 इक्वल टू P0 म्हणजे एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर at the surface of liquid, P1 equal to P0 and P2 equal to P and H2 which is equal to H equal to D. So this value we will substitute in equation 2 and the equation will become, see here, P equal to P0 plus D rho Z. So this is a required expression for total pressure at a point inside the liquid surface, which is at depth D below the free surface of liquid. And this total pressure is equal to sum of atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to imaginary cylinder of liquid. So this is expression. Equation 3 gives, this equation gives the total pressure, which is also called as a absolute pressure at depth D below the liquid surface. म्हणजे liquid surface च्या inside ला एखाद्या point जवळचं total pressure म्हणजे absolute pressure काढायचं असेल तर आपल्याला दोन pressure ची addition करावी लागेल. First one, atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to liquid column above that point. So this equation 3 gives the total pressure or expression for absolute pressure at depth D below the liquid surface. And if you see the equation 3 carefully, it is observed that pressure at depth D below the liquid surface is greater than atmospheric pressure by the amount D rho Z. So this is expression for absolute pressure at depth D below the liquid surface. Now in the second case, we will find expression for absolute pressure at height H above the liquid surface. See here, in second case, we will find expression for pressure at height H above the liquid surface. And to find this expression for absolute pressure at height H above the liquid surface, we will refer this diagram. So in this diagram, the imaginary cylinder of liquid is shifted in such way that the bottom surface of that imaginary cylinder is at the top of liquid surface. So in this diagram, the bottom of imaginary cylinder is shifted to the free surface of liquid and this label be H2. And in this diagram also, the reference point from which the heights H1 and H2 measured is nothing but the free surface of liquid. That's why H2 will be taken as 0 and H1 will be greater than H2, but in this case H1 minus H2, which is nothing but H, which is height of air column above free surface of liquid. So in this diagram, the top surface of cylinder, jawalcha pressure P1, apan te P manaycha, ani bottom surface jo cylinder cha hai, it is on the free surface of liquid. Tyamule bottom surface jawalcha pressure P2, that will become equal to atmospheric pressure. So in order to find the expression for absolute pressure, we will consider expression for pressure at level S2 that we have already derived, the expression is P2 equal to P1 plus H1 minus H2 into rho g. So this expression is giving us pressure at level S2, at point S2. So in this equation, we will substitute the following values. Which values? In place of P2, we will write P0. In place of P1, we will write P. In place of H1, we will write H. And in place of H2, we will write 0. And this rho, previously in first case, the rho was the density of liquid. Because the cylinder, imaginary cylinder, is of liquid or water. But in this second case, this imaginary cylinder is of air. त्यामुळे त्या इमॅजिनरी सिलेंडरनं एअरला इन्क्लोज केलेलं आहे. दॅट्स वाय हिअर वी शुड रिप्लेस रो बाय डेन्सिटी ऑफ एअर. सो सबस्टिट्यूटिंग फॉलोइंग व्हॅल्यूज इन इक्वेशन टू, विच व्हॅल्यूज? सी हिअर, H1 इक्वल टू एच, सी इन द डायग्रॅम, P1 इक्वल टू पी, P2 इक्वल टू P0, दिस व्हॅल्यू, H2 इक्वल टू 0, कारण आपण या ठिकाणचा रेफरन्स पॉइंट हा लिक्विडचा फ्री सरफेस कन्सिडर केलेला आहे. त्यामुळे H2 इक्वल टू 0 असणार, H1 इक्वल टू हाईट ऑफ दॅट सिलेंडर H, अँड डेन्सिटी विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय डेन्सिटी ऑफ एअर. आणि जर आपण ह्या इक्वेशन मध्ये सबस्टिट्यूट केलं तर आपल्याला मिळेल P2 विच इज नथिंग बट P0, P1 इक्वल टू P. सो P0 इक्वल टू P प्लस H मायनस 0 डेन्सिटी ऑफ एअर इन टू जी. आणि त्या इक्वेशन मधून तुम्हाला पी ची व्हॅल्यू काढायची असेल, सो प्रेशर ऍट हाईट H अबाव द लिक्विड सरफेस, H हाईट वर, लिक्विड सरफेस पासून H हाईट वरच प्रेशर तुम्हाला फाइंड आउट करायचं असेल P, तर आपल्याला इक्वेशन असं लिहिता येईल, P इक्वल टू P0 मायनस H इंटू डेन्सिटी ऑफ एअर इंटू जी. सो दिस इक्वेशन फाईव्ह गिव्स इक्वेशन फॉर टोटल प्रेशर और अब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट हाईट H. यू कॅन सी इन दिस डायग्रॅम, ऍट हाईट H अबाव द लिक्विड सर्फेस. सो दिस इक्वेशन फाईव्ह गिव्स द टोटल प्रेशर और अब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट हाईट H above the liquid surface. And if you see the equation carefully, it is found that absolute pressure at height H above the liquid surface is less than atmospheric pressure. This one is the less than atmospheric pressure by this value. Ya value na manje H density into air into G, ya value na या ठिकाणचं ऍब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट हाईट H हे लेस आहे, बट ऍब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट डेप्थ इनसाइड द लिक्विड इज ग्रेटर दॅन ऍटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कॅन फाइंड द एक्सप्रेशन्स फॉर ऍब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट डेप्थ D बिलो द लिक्विड सरफेस, अँड ऑल्सो वी कॅन फाइंड द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर ऍब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऍट हाईट H above the liquid surface. And we come to know that absolute pressure at depth is greater than atmospheric pressure, while absolute pressure at height H is less than atmospheric pressure. Now, in this way, we learn the second concept of pressure, which is the absolute pressure or total pressure. Now, the third concept we will learn, which is called as the gauge pressure. So in order to learn this gauge pressure, we will refer this diagram. So in this diagram, we have considered a tank or vessel containing liquid like water. And inside that tank, we have considered imaginary cylinder of liquid or of water. And this cylinder is shifted such that top of that cylinder is at the free surface of the water, and bottom of that cylinder is at depth D. So we know that total pressure or absolute pressure at depth D inside the liquid surface is the sum of atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to this liquid column. So we can write here total pressure at depth D below the liquid surface at rest. म्हणजे यातील जे लिक्विड आहे that liquid is at rest. आणि या लिक्विडचं total pressure at depth D, you can see this one is the depth of that point. At depth D below the liquid surface at rest, which is open to atmosphere, this liquid is also open to atmosphere, is the sum of atmospheric pressure, see here P0, atmospheric pressure acting on the surface of liquid, and pressure due to liquid at depth D, म्हणजे D rho g, ह्या liquid column चा pressure आणि atmospheric pressure ह्या दोघांची addition gives us total pressure at depth D below the liquid surface. So we can write the mathematical expression for this statement. The total pressure at depth D, P equal to atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to liquid column of depth D, किंवा height D. So in this equation, what shows? This equation shows that this absolute pressure or total pressure is greater than atmospheric pressure by this factor. So this equation shows that the total pressure P, which is also called as the absolute pressure, is greater than atmospheric pressure P0 by an amount D rho g. So this means there is an excess pressure inside the liquid. So this excess of pressure at depth D in liquid is called Gauss pressure. So clearly we come to know from this equation is that the absolute pressure or total pressure at a point inside the liquid is greater than atmospheric pressure. So we can take the difference between absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure, and that difference gives us excess pressure at depth D in a liquid. And that difference between absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure is called as a Gauss pressure. Therefore, Gauss pressure is what? Gauss pressure gives us the difference between the absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure. That means P minus P0. That difference is called as a Gauss pressure. Therefore, mathematical equation for Gauss pressure. See here. Therefore, Gauss pressure, which is the difference between absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure, is equal to D rho g. Thus, Gauss pressure at a point in a liquid, म्हणजे Gauss pressure जर liquid मधील एखाद्या point जवळच find out करायचं असेल, तर simply आपल्याला difference घ्यावा लागेल. पुन्हा मधला difference between absolute pressure at that point and atmospheric pressure. So in this way, we learn two more concepts related with the pressure. In the earlier lecture, we learned the first concept, which is the atmospheric pressure. And in this lecture, we learn absolute pressure and Gauss pressure. So with this, we are ending this lecture.